Welcome back to your source of hot .NET and C# takes. I'm going to talk about this tweet. This poor guy wrote, "I've got an amazing idea for the .NET team. After .NET 9 and C# 11 comes out, how about giving everyone a couple of years off? The treadmill is getting tiring for people actually using this stuff." Now, this poor guy was the main character on .NET Twitter a couple of weeks ago, and it was immediately met with classic Twitter quote tweet pylons, particularly from Imo Lansworth, who's actually a .NET program manager on the .NET teams. It's hard to disagree. The predictability of the schedule, a big feature. Microsoft MVPs got involved. Nah. You know, I love these guys. They're top guys. But the poor sod that this happened to was me. The response from the community was basically split down the middle. This guy says, 1,000% agree with you. All of our devs are getting exhausted at this new release schedule. This guy says, agree regarding language design. Too much change for the sake of keeping the language design team busy. Ooh, that's a hell of an accusation. Ozzy says, agreed. The pace of the core API changes way too fast. Keeps going. Darius says, I do believe we are reaching the point of diminishing returns on C#. Ooh, just wish I'd have an extra long-term support version. Yeah. Oh, I dream for a VLTS extended to 10 years. Well, let's talk about this. Now, if you actually have a look at the thread itself, there is one reply, which, unironically, is the most important one, and that is this. .NET has a bigger problem with some people enjoying the tail end of their experience. This is actually the most meaningful tweet reply on this thread, and let me tell you why. I believe there is a adoption problem with .NET and C# at the moment. I don't have the numbers because I don't work for Microsoft, but I see it out there, and I think there are a couple of things that the team is focusing on that are currently not the right thing to focus on. Let's talk about first C# itself. What's new in C# 10? Look at all this new stuff. That's cool. Next year, what's new in C# 11? Wow, this is really helping the adoption of C#. People are really going to start using this language because it now has file local types. Let's go, 1 year later, C# 12, look at this. Oh, fantastic. Just what I've been waiting for. Inline arrays, ref read-only parameters. Yes, let's go. C# 13, another year later. I mean, I don't think this is actually helping adoption. So now I have this channel, I get access to real users of C#, and quite a lot of beginners as well. And this is a common take I see. Craigology here says, I just started learning C#.NET and I don't understand why they make changes every other year. Changing the syntax, isn't it counterproductive? Well, for beginners, I definitely think it is counterproductive. And if we want to keep C# and .NET actually a viable thing going forward, we need beginners that are not scared by every year another 20 things that they think they have to learn. And people will say, "Don't, you don't have to learn them," but they think they do, and that's the problem. Now, obviously, the people working on C# are the best in the land at C#. They work for Microsoft. You guys are the goats, I think, is what we call people these days. However, let's talk about other web frameworks that have things like this. Django has an admin site built in by the core team. You just get an admin screen. This is great. Laravel, it has a Laravel admin. This is fantastic. This is used by lots and lots of people, and there are various others in the ecosystem. So why for C# and .NET is it left to people like Muggins here to actually try desperately to build what .NET needs? Microsoft has the people. There is no reason why, when you create a new web project, there cannot be an admin panel that just shows up with your entity model. Please, you could be spending your time doing that and helping .NET and C# be a great web framework. Here's another thing. Imagine you want to secure a JSON API within your application with no external server dependencies that you don't control. Well, if you're on Rails, you could just use this amazing thing called Devise. That's pretty cool. Being supported for decades by the community. And it's even, look at this. This is the money shot. It's MIT license. Fantastic. So you don't have to pay diddly squat to use it. On Node.js, we get Passport.js, which does the same thing. this is fantastic, has some corporate sponsors, so they're not starving, unlike most .NET's open source developers. And look, it's so important, even the Azure team contributed an Azure Active Directory component to it. That's great. So in C#.NET land, I want to build a JSON API and have and issue my own JWT tokens. What are the options? Here we go. ASP.NET Core Identity. To secure web APIs and SPAs, use one of the following. Microsoft Entra ID. Azure Active Directory B2C. Or Duende Identity Server. Do you remember Identity Server? Probably peak.NET that was, but again, zero support, couldn't pay the bills, so they had to go commercial. I mean, you cannot write a secure API without either using Azure or using Duende Identity Server. If I'm wrong, please write a comment and tell me that I'm wrong and that there is something out there that the official Microsoft documentation has missed. Please let me know, because I really think the amazing team could be spending time filling in these gaps, which would help adoption. The next thing we need to talk about is the support cycle, which came up in that Twitter thread. So currently we have an LTS for 3 years from release. Yeah, the even numbers are LTS releases, you get 3 years of patches. That's okay, but let's look at it in a historical context. And the only blog post out there that actually really discusses this is this one on the InEdit website that embarrassingly points out that .NET Framework 4.8 is still under support, yeah? And it'll be still under support long past anything that you decide to build your apps on today. The messaging is all wrong and it's confusing and horrible. Also, this is interesting. Yeah, okay, you get even numbers, get 3 years of releases, 3 years of support, but where have I seen that before? Well, Node.js is exactly the same. Yeah, even numbers get 3 years of releases. Here we go, 3 years of LTS support, active and maintenance over a period of 3 years for an even number release, and then the odd numbers are basically experimental releases, exactly the same as .NET. Now, I think this is okay for Node.js because you don't pay to use Node.js. Right. If you're a genuine organization using C# and .NET, you're obviously going to be paying for Visual Studio or C# Toolkit or even JetBrains Rider. You know, it costs cash. So this should be better than Node.js. The support story should be better. And what's really worrying is that if you shipped an app, for example, October 2022, here, on the latest LTS version of .NET, you have about 1 year before you have to upgrade everything. And, well, I hope you're ready, because despite people saying, oh, you just update it in your CS proj file, well, yes, you've got to do your build pipelines as well. And if you've got on the microservices wagon, you've probably got 100 apps to separately upgrade. But anyway, you've got to deal with the breaking changes in .NET 7. Yeah, okay, let's go. I mean, this isn't, how do you know that your app isn't going to be affected by this until you get there? So you can't even plan. So you've got the breaking changes there. You'll also need to deal with the breaking changes in .NET 8. Maybe you're lucky and none of this happens. So this isn't just an upgrade despite what people says. It needs testing, there's a release cycle, and it upsets business stakeholders. Why am I dealing with this? I thought we were done with this app. And yeah, apps are for life, not just for Christmas, but that's not how enterprises work. So what am I proposing to increase and safeguard the adoption of .NET going forward? I think we should extend the LTS period to 6 years. I think there should be an extra 3 years of just security patches. Yeah. People pay for Microsoft stuff. So what are they paying for exactly that they can't just get for free with Node.js? Please, I mean, humor me here. Yeah. I think it should be possible to ship an enterprise app at the latest at the time LTS version and get at least 4 years of security patches. .NET has a huge advantage because if you create a framework dependent version, Microsoft Update will update the underlying runtime for you, which doesn't happen with Node.js. So you could put an app on a server, turn on Microsoft Update, and genuinely kind of be safe for a while. Let's extend .NET 6 LTS out till .NET 11. Yeah, how about that? There are critical apps out there today running actual quite important infrastructure that have no plan. It's not on their roadmap to upgrade their LTS version. And then, you know, what happened to this, right? Yeah, Satya's new thing, guys. Security is important. What happens if we get a security issue with .NET 6 1 month after .NET 9 is released? Are you not going to patch it? You're going to patch it, right? Yeah? So let's just make it official and extend this way past into a six-year window. That'd be nice. Just security. I don't need performance fixes or new features. Just security. Whew, that was therapeutic. Thank you very much for watching. Let's do an experiment. If you agree with me, press the like button. Does .NET need more support? Will that help adoption? Press the like button. If you think I'm an idiot, you can also just tell me I'm an idiot in the comments and I will try to tactfully respond. Thank you for watching.